MV Agusta makes some of the most rewarding and sensational motorcycles that I've ever ridden. But by a natural extension of that, these Italian exotics are quite high strung and they're not very easy to live with. The motorcycle we have here today though, this might tell a different story. This is the Turismo Veloce 800 and it's a bike the company likes to call the Everyday MV. So, can this bike really offer the best of both worlds? Well, that's what we're here to find out. The good news is that the Turismo is an authentic MV in the ways that matter. First, it's got an exotic sounding name that proves everything sounds cooler in Italian. And then there's the way it looks. There's far too many ugly SUVs out there that point out just how hard it is to make a big and tall vehicle look good. MV has just outdone themselves in this regard, and I imagine that half the people who buy one will do so because this bike looks so good. Every single angle on this motorcycle is a treat to behold, but the most familiar one is the face, which looks like it came straight off MV's super sport exotic, the F3. The side profile is dominated by a muscular 21.5-litre fuel tank, as well as that fascinating seat arrangement. I've never seen such an ornate subframe design, and it's quite amazing how MV has managed to make two rather large and comfy seats look this sensational. It's also impossible to miss the tiny three exhaust pipes and that exposed rear wheel, both design features that are also lifted from the F3. Move over to the rear and you'll be awestruck at that tall and slim tail, which is completely free from boring things like indicators and a number plate. There's also so much to take in when it comes to the smaller details, and if you look hard enough, you'll see that even the tail lamp shape is a play on the alphabets M and V. In that sense, it really isn't much of an exaggeration to compare an MV Agusta with art. In fact, that's exactly where the company got their tagline from. True to its name, the Turismo Veloce was built to cover big distances, and there are plenty of small creature comforts to help with this. The windscreen is height adjustable, cruise control is standard, and heated grips can be had as an option. We counted 4 different charging ports all over, and there are a couple of small cubbies on either side of the instrument console as well. Speaking of, this is the first MV in India to offer a full color display, which is quite informative, but also quite cluttered to look at. Now, I could go on gushing about how fantastic this bike looks, but a pretty face will only take you so far. Thankfully, this MV has much more substance under the skin. This 3-cylinder engine, for example, it's almost identical to what you'll find in the wild Brutale 800, and that's a very good thing. At 110 HP, this engine makes exactly the same amount of power as the Brutale, but the torque figure is slightly higher. The motor feels and sounds nearly the same as well, with a thrilling scream at high revs, accompanied by a tiny but consistent amount of vibration. It really is an exciting, action-packed motor that feels faster than the spec sheet suggests. If anything, the Turismo's heavier weight along with a longer wheelbase means it isn't as prone to power wheelies as the Brutale and the F3, but hit a small crest in the road and the front wheel will quite happily wave at the sky. MV's bi-directional quickshifter is standard on this bike and it continues to be the best I've experienced so far. Another MV aspect that remains is the fact that the ride-by-wire throttle feels artificial and the throttle response is sharp but not very consistent, especially in sport mode. Talking about electronics, this is another area that's just like the Brutale and you get 4 riding modes, 8 level traction control and switchable ABS. The hardware components are also very familiar, with a trellis frame holding the bike together. Suspension is handled by the trademark combination of a 43mm Marzocchi fork and a Sachs rear shock, both of which are adjustable. The brakes come straight off MV sports bikes and the twin Brembo front disc setup works just as well as you'd expect. It comes as no surprise then that even though this MV stands tall, it's very happy to lean over in the corners. I never ran out of cornering clearance and the grip from the Bridgestone tyres was never a problem either. Through a glorious morning spent tearing through the twisties, the Turismo made it apparent that it holds a bias towards the sport side of Sport Toro, and considering that this is an MV Agusta, I'd expect nothing less. In terms of riding thrills, the Turismo Veloce does not disappoint.
So we've established that it looks like an MV and it goes like one too. But what about the everyday part? Well, there's a number of positives in that aspect too.
First of all, there's the riding position, which has you sitting nice and upright, although the foot peg position is a bit sporty.
Wind protection is decent, but it's not excessive, which is a good thing in our hot climate. I also discovered that the bike doesn't need to be ridden flat out to be fun, and it is quite happy to settle into a lazy cruise on the highway. But the biggest win comes in the form of ride quality. On most MVs, if you encounter a pothole at the last minute, there's not much more you can do apart from keeping the throttle open and sending a sincere set of thoughts and prayers to your higher power of choice. But the Turismo is so much better in this regard, and even though the suspension is firm, it can genuinely cope with our horrible road conditions thanks to 160mm of wheel travel on offer. That being said, this is not an off-roader because it just doesn't have the ground clearance, and you do need to be a little cautious over very tall speed breakers.
So yes, the Turismo is vastly easier than any MV before to live with, but it's not all perfect. For starters, the seat height is really tall. And as Sameer, our cinematographer, who's 5 feet 4 inches tall, is now going to demonstrate, the Turismo may be the everyday MV, but it's not for everyone.
That everyday part may be a bit of a stretch in India as well, because this bike does not like getting stuck in the average big city evening commute. The heat buildup after about half an hour crawling traffic is quite extreme, and if you don't give the engine enough space to cool, it will eventually cut out. And while we're addressing negatives, quality could stand to improve in certain areas as well. The design and finish are mostly excellent, but we did notice that moisture had seeped into some of the lights and the rear left indicator stopped working altogether. And while the new switchgear is a big improvement, the switches themselves still feel far too cheap for a bike that costs this much money. And at ₹18.99 lakh ex-showroom, this is a serious amount of money indeed. We're talking about the kind of money that will get you a Ducati Multistrada 1260S, a bike that offers as good as 50 horsepower more, as well as electronically adjustable suspension, and that's a hard pill to swallow.
Now, I'm not going to stand here and tell you that this bike offers any significant form of value for money. It's actually quite far from it. But the Turismo Veloce does have a number of redeeming qualities if you find yourself fascinated by the idea of owning an MV in India.
The thing about MV Agustas is that every time I ride one on a nice road or the racetrack, the flood of emotions completely drowns out concerns about the price. The Turismo offers most of these feelings, but crucially, its ability to do that doesn't fall apart the moment the road stops being nice. If you're a road rider who absolutely adores what MV Agustas are all about, and if value for money plays no part in your vocabulary, this MV is probably the sweetest of the lot.